Hello everyone. In this video, we will discuss about operating system services. So what are all the services that could be provided by the operating system? So that we will see one by one. So before going to the services, so what is the actual functionality that must be provided by the operating system? Let us see. So first, operating system will provide the environment with which the programs ought to be executed. So we can execute either the program or we can also say that some process will be executed. So it will provide the environment in order to execute something in the system. So that is what the operating system will do. So internally, the operating system may vary from one to another. So if you want to design any new operating system, then what are all the goals? So that must be well defined before going for the design phase. So you must define your goals in a brief manner. And afterwards, these goals, whatever the thing you defined, all those things are based on some algorithms as well as some strategies. So afterwards, you can go and design your own operating system. So this operating system may be focused in three views, which mean the first one is how it is actually providing the services. So how we are getting the services. And the next view is how it is actually interacted with the user. So many user application may run in the system. So how the operating system gets interacted with the user. So how it is providing the interface for the user and also between the hardware. So the next view, the third view, is nothing but how it is actually the components has been connected internally. So these three aspects of the operating system we're going to discuss one by one. So first one is how it is providing the services and what are all the services that could be provided by the operating system. So before going to the operating system services, I would like to tell about this, the main view of the operating system. So already we discussed about this diagram. So here we have as the bottom layer as the hardware, and afterwards we have the operating system, because the connection between the hardware and the user program, in between you should have this operating system so that we can execute many user application, and all those hardware resources must be used only through the operating system. So here we have lot of OS services like error detection, program execution, IO operations, file systems, communication, resource allocation, accounting, protection and security. So we are going to discuss all these services one by one. And we have the next layer as the system call. So the system call, which we know already. What do you mean by system call? It is nothing but it is a interface between the operating system and the user program. So whenever you want to execute any OS programs, which is some system programs, you want to execute any predefined, you want to use any predefined function, then all those things will be done only with the help of the system call. So we should use system calls in our program, and automatically all those OS program must be executed. And the next one, we have the user interface. In order to get interact with the user application, only through this user interface, the operating system will control the user application. So here we have lot of interface that were available. So we will discuss one by one. Graphical user interface, batch interface, command line interface. So let us see one by one. So here in the top layer, we have the user program and other system program also. Okay. So first, the functionality or the main services that could be provided by the operating system or user interface, program execution, IO operation, file system manipulation or file system operations, communication, error detection, resource allocation, accounting and protection and security. So first one is user interface. What do you mean by user interface? So operating system must have, all the operating system must have this user interface. Without this user interface, it cannot interact with the user application. So this is what the main functionality of the user interface. So it takes several forms, and some of the user interface such as command line interface, batch interface and graphical user interface. So what is it, command line interface? So it is this particular interface is used for text commands. So if you want to enter some text, or if you want to provide the method for entering the text into the system, then we can go with this interface, that is command line interface. Next one is batch interface. This particular interface is used for providing the commands and the directives in order to execute those commands, and these will be entered into the files, and the files also be executed by the operating system. Next one is graphical user interface. So this GUI, which is nothing but it is a Windows system in order to direct many IO devices. Suppose if you want to choose any of the option from the menu, or if you want to do some selections, and if you want to give some enter some input to the user through the keyboard into the system, then you can go with this interface, that is graphical user interface. So in order to provide all these functionality, we are using the user interface. So it is one of the major services that could be provided by the operating system. And the next one is program execution. So what do you mean by program? So whichever the program or set of instruction that could be framed by the user is said to be the program. And program, we are just loading into the memory before execution. So initially we have loaded the program into the memory, and from the memory it will be taken for execution and it will be given to CPU for execution. So while it is executing, it may require or it will use the IO devices or any other resources. So after completing its execution, so it will end its execution. So the execution of the program can be ended in two ways. One is normal execution, and normal termination, and another one is abnormal termination. So normal termination, which is nothing but, so after executing all the set of operations in the program, then it will be terminated normally. Abnormal termination, which is nothing but if it produces any error or any illegal use of memory, so which is nothing but if you get any error, then which is nothing but abnormal termination. So this is what we are trying to understand about the program execution. So next service is nothing but IO operation. So IO operation, if any of the program or the process is currently executed by the CPU, it may require IO devices. So it may need some IO set of operations to be executed, right? So at that time, so it will, CPU will stop executing its own set of operations, and the process will be given for IO devices in order to perform its IO operation, right? So user cannot control the IO devices or IO set of operation, because in order to provide the efficiency as well as the protection, so these IO devices must be entirely controlled by the operating system and not any of the user. So this is what the important thing that we should know about the IO operation. And the next one is file system manipulation. So under this file system manipulation, there are a lot of file operations that can be executed by the operating system. So file operations such as read operation, write operation, and create operation, then delete operation, then search operation, then list operation. So all these are said to be a basic set of operation which we can perform in file system. So, in addition to this operation, operating system will provide another one wide operation is said to be a permission operation. So, we are allotting some permission to the files. Even this permission has been done by the owner of the file. So, he can provide some permission. Some of the access may be denied for that particular file by certain users. So, any unauthorized user may not allow able to access this particular file. So, this is what, for this purpose, we have this permission operation. This will also be provided by the operating system. So, next service by the operating system is communication. So this communication scheme is nothing but the communication takes place in between the process. So if suppose one of the process wants to exchange information to another process, then the communication takes place in between those two processes. Okay, so no matter how those two process belongs to the same computer or if it belongs to the different computers. Suppose if the process communicates to another process which is stored in some other computer, that is different computer, and those computer must be connected through network, then only communication is possible. So here the communication is implemented via shared memory. So if you have some shared memory concept, then automatically the communication is possible in between any two processes. Otherwise, we can also go with some other technique called message passing. So message passing is also applicable in between any two processes, and this can be done purely by the operating system. So it will create some packets, which is nothing but some content or a set of information, and it will follow some well-defined or predefined format in order to make some packets, and this packets will be sent from one process to another process. This is how communication is achieved in case of the operating system. So this is also one of the main service that could be provided by the operating system. So because we keep on creating many dependent processes, so dependent process, which is nothing but one process purely depend on other process, which means whatever the content we have, that could be shared by some other process. That is what dependent process. So if you are working with a dependent process environment, so obviously this service must be provided by the operating system. And the next service is error detection. So this error detection, which is nothing but whatever the error we are getting in the system. So there are a lot of errors you may get based on the resources, whatever you are using. So whatever the errors you are getting, so that must be controlled by the operating system. The operating system will not only detect the error, it will also correct the error constantly. But how we are getting errors? So errors may occur because of CPU cycles. So which means if CPU is executing any one of the process, so in between the execution, if it gets any interrupts like hardware or software interrupt, then automatically the process will be stopped there. The CPU will stop their execution. So which means you're getting some kind of error. So it is a kind of error. Suppose if you get any error in the memory itself. So suppose if you are accessing the memory, which means if you want to get any of the program or the process which is already stored in the memory. So what happens there? If the finding or searching process that were not available in the particular location in the memory, then that is a kind of error. So it is also error, and that could be handled by the operating system. Suppose you may get error because of I/O devices. Because of I/O devices also you may get error, which means if you want to take the printout, suppose if the paper is not there in the printer, so what happens? It turns a kind of error. It stops its execution abruptly. So lack of paper in the printer is a kind of, it's a best example for input-output error. That is I/O error, right? So even if you get error in user program, you may get error in user program. So if you're trying to execute any one of the program, and that program may produce lot of errors, right? So illegal use of input. So if you're giving, if you're not providing the correct input, if you're not getting the correct output, so you may get errors even in the user program. So there are lot of chances you may get errors in various types of resources, whatever you're using. All these kinds of error must be handled by the operating system properly. It has to sort out all those errors and it has to produce the correct output to the user. So this is one of the important services could be provided by the operating system. And the next one is resource allocation. So resource allocation, so operating system must manage all the resources properly. So management of resources must be the most important activity by the operating system. So it must allocate all the resources whenever it is needed by the CPU, user, or even by the CPU. So, in this, if you are working with the environment like multi-user or multi-job, so if you want to execute all the programs concurrently, so if there is any parallel execution, then resource sharing is one of the important tasks of in that environment, and the resource sharing. So in case of that resource sharing, though, it has to allocate the resources properly. So here CPU scheduling is one of the major tasks for operating system. So CPU scheduling, which is nothing but whatever the resources that is required by the CPU must be scheduled accordingly. So that could be done by the operating system. Okay, so resources, which is nothing but the CPU cycle or the memory or even the CPU time or everything was said to be the resources. Okay, so next one is accounting. Accounting is nothing but we need to keep track of the user, so on which the user is using what kind of resources and how much of resources has been used by the user, or else how long they are actually using that resources. So like that, we need to keep track of information about the user logs and the resources that can be shared by the multiple users. So why we need to store all these information? So which means this record keeping is primarily used for accounting, which means you can provide some bills to the user on the basis of how they have used the resources. Otherwise, we can also store for the usage statistics. Usage statistics, which is, it is one of the primary tool which is used by many researchers or even the developers. Okay, in order to improve their computing services, they will use this particular tool, that is usage statistics. So how long the resources has been used and how what kind of resources used most frequently. So all those information will be maintained in this particular tool. This is what accounting. And the next one is protection and security. So this is one of the major services that could be provided by the operating system, because if the owner want to control the entire set of the file system or even whatever the information he wants to control, so if you are giving only access to the owner, so what happens here, even some other authorized user may not access that particular content or even the files. So the operating system must control the entire file system. So he can give some of the access to some kind of user and some unauthorized user if he is accessing any of the file system. So he can protect it. So protection, which is nothing but the operating system must have the entire control of the file system or whatever the information we are maintaining for executing the process. And the next one is security. Security is somewhat different from protection, which means any of the outsiders of the system may want to access the files or even any of the confidential information, which means any of the system programs or OS program, he may want to hack it or he may want to access it. We need to secure it properly. So we should authenticate each and every user whoever logs in the system in order to access any of the files. So authentication can be done with the help of the login and the password details. So if the recognized password or the login details, if the user gave, then the user can access or allowable to access the data or even the file system. So this is what the protection and security services, which is maintained by the operating system. So these are all the main important functionality provided by the operating system. Thank you.